rocket start. The real-time sinking of the RMS Klepper. Yep. It was a beautiful night, actually, and the Klepper was just departing New York City. Ignore that. Ignore the modern lights and stuff. It's New York, and ignore that there's no skyscrapers and there's a runway and it's dead mountainy, and that island. Ignore it. Let's turn away. It was a beautiful day, but I mean night. But there was a loud explosion. That was an awful explosion sound. Really cheesy too. But Le Klepper was sinking. Passengers unaware of the situation, since it was a cold night. It was May, but it was quite a cold night, as they were quite northern. Yes, it was a bit choppy, ignore that. By the way, I've completely redid this room. I hated it, but now I've made it so I like it. Well, don't worry. There will be a button here to turn on these lights. Boop! Well, yeah. And I even put a little grill. Like, so if children are here, they can't walk in, see? No matter what you do, you can't get to it. Wait. Haha, see? You literally can't. Anyway, boop! Passengers noticed the slide, police. It seemed to be a bit worse from when she first departed. Right, I'm sorry, but it's quite choppy. Right, I'm gonna reduce the lag a bit. Okay, that's honestly better. Many passengers wanted to stay inside. Once again, I'm gonna add a light to the bridge. I don't know when I'll do it, but I will, even though I keep on saying I will, and I never do, I will. The puddles seemed to get a bit worse. And one of the lifeboats swaying in the wind. There was another loud explosion. Oh no, a lifeboat seemed to snap off. Oh well, it is fine. But the ship was still listing. In fact, it was listing worse and worse by the second. Getting on a dangerous angle. Unfortunately, the staircase had just been mopped very, very recently, and some poor individuals slipped down. And one unfortunate woman broke her arm. The space of Titanic. After the coal shifting, it was leaning to port a bit like this. Grant's staircase was mopped. Woman slipped. My lifeboat was launched. In an emergency skip. But two loud bangs were heard. Bow! Bow! And the ship was listing ever so more. The ship was in serious trouble as water was really starting to fill onto the forecastle. Passengers were getting concerned. And unfortunately, at that fateful moment, I'll make it a bit brighter for you. Pretend it's pitch black, because you're not really meant to see that. At that fateful moment, some of the ship's power began to fail. Much of the ship was surrounded in darkness. Only a few generators that were not flooded were still working, powering the vessel. Thank God she is still a steamship. But unfortunately, some of her main engines died. In fact, no, pretend it happened at a cold, like, morning, I guess, like, where the sun's barely up and the sky's still very dark. Pretend it happened then. The ship very, very screwed over the bow. Torch off. Cargo hold. Boop. The cargo hold slipped open and water's gouging down, forcing water to go into the bellies of the ship even faster. The auxiliary anchors clean as lost power and swung to port side because the ship is leaning on the port side. Water is now chugging down the promenade deck. More power begins to fail across the liner. The elevator lights still burning on the generators. Try to refire the main engine, but unfortunately it would not work out too well, as another explosion was heard, the ship going down fast. I will stop that noise soon. Oh, don't worry. The ship still powering, chugging through the awful waters of the cold night. Still chuffing through the water, pushing anything in her way out of the way. Except from at that moment, the bottom pump was lost. The rest of her engines just shut off. The liner going down by the head. Very little lights burning. Sichuan, I guess. Barely any lights remaining as the crippled liner started to plunge. Until, at that fateful moment, 7 minutes and 15 seconds in, the lights went out. The ship surrounded in darkness. Don't worry about the elevator lights, I can't turn them off, they're always on. Like, seriously, I cannot do anything about it. The dark silhouettes of the ship singing. It made the passengers cry, made them sad, but in an esprit of luck, they at least started to calm, still noticeable, but it was calmer and calmer. People worrying, the lounge flooding, this is meant to, wait. It's going to be a lounge, that's going to be the thingy, reception room. I guess they're kind of the same, but they're not. The ship was now flooding fast whenever the water felt like it would go into in time for me to say this entire sentence. Why is it not flooding? Yeah. It's awfully terrifying. Let's just fix that. Oh, there's the water. Hi. Let's get out of here before we die. The tear is creeping through. Let's try to have the lights on. Oh yeah, look at that. Water slowly filling the room. Right, let's turn off the lights before I die. The ship surrounded in darkness. The port least fully corrected itself last second before the ship would make an awful move, plunging, the bridge starting to slip under the waves as the final part of the roof never sees daylight again. The masts, they are slipping under the first class staircase. Filling with water fast, water gouging it. Oh, it happened! Then, at that moment, there was a terrible explosion. When the ship came to the rest, her stern falling. Her stern seemed to be balanced But little did the passengers know that the stern was sinking and fast too. The stern seemed to be bobbing fine, like a cork, as the passengers were saying. They said they were shrouded in darkness, but could still see thanks to a tiny bit of sunlight and a bit of moonlight. There was near a few islands, so they were okay. But unfortunately, the ship was not. Water started to fill onto the boat's deck whenever it felt like it, which is right now. Water was spilling onto the boat's deck. The ship once again was going down. Snap, after it snapped in half, this was the final plunge of the ship. The final plunge, the stern was flooding, the propellers coming out the water, the last funnel under the water, much of the ship coming out the water, going under at the same time. The final plunge is happening, and it's not going slow. Wait, I'll make it a bit brighter so you can see. Not too bright, but a bit brighter. Final plunge. As the Klepper, legendary ocean liner, had met a fear. Diving down.
Oh, I think it stopped.
12-ish years later.
Jesus Christ.
That's literally going full Titanic. Oh no, it's decided to slow. Diving down onto the wreck. Stern's falling. Ignore it. It's just sitting to the back. That's perfect. Oh look, the bow is actually somewhat drifted. I know it still was moving at time of breakup, but it drifted a bit. Once upon a time, beautiful individuals were walking upon this deck. Little did they know that one day the beautiful liner would go under. Deck mortals, machinery, only yours several times as the ship was only on her 12th voyage. Britannic painted rooms. Imagine being a first-class passenger on this magnificent vessel. Klepper, her blueprints were discovered at that awful moment. Much of the ship.
Whoa, the light has a shadow, isn't that cool?
Oh, right. Turning down, looking at the staircase, passengers would have seen water filling here upon the moment of sinking. Through the luxurious dining reception room, passengers used to eat here, talk here, make friends here, communicate. Fireplace still has grill in place, but the fireplace is out. Blocking elevators, never to be used again. Painting still intact. You could tell the panic of the lifeboats as they had not even been fully checked out that night. The Marconi room. People used to do SOS. They tried to rescue the liner. Unfortunately, MV Ponder did not make it in time. And the chat room. Once yours to tell where the ship was. Useless now. Gone. Under the water. Wrecked. The ship. Even now still has a puddle. The ship pitching upward. The cargo hold. The mast. The crow's nest. People once would have spotted anything in the way from here.
Yes, it's ridiculously small. I clicked out the game.
Just a look over. Realize what a magnificent ship they were on. Looking back, they could see all funnels towering below. Under the
the drink as a first class passenger on the promenade. What the hell?
Why is there a random cube? You can see that too, right?
Yeah, it looks like a random reddish cube.
What the hell? Why? What do you do? What purpose? Oh god! What purpose do you serve? Stop.
It's a dry spot! What the hell?
I'm not drowning. I really am not. Found a bug! I'm gonna report that later.
Now, unlike the bow of the ship, the stern was vertical. Swimming away from the bow and swimming towards the ship's stern, landed on the rocks, crashing down slowly, day by day, starting to fall on itself, destroying everything. But while it's still intact, second-class promenade passengers would have looked through there at the ship's final moments, sliding down, begging for mercy. But the ocean is one cruel place. The door, the dining saloon, chairs somehow in the same position, domes, windows somehow not shattered, elevator, swimming. Left but David, the third class it's dining saloon, very small. Unfortunately, great ocean liner, once amazing, the ship of Julian's is now just a lusty old wreck, useless to modern man. Thank God she sank in shallow water, as her stern is quite close to the ocean's surface.
Yeah, that's only the difference. And so is that half. Look, you can... It's still got natural daylight. This half, though, Jesus Christ.
Ship or not, it was still beautiful.
I mean, wrecked or not.
Time after diving, one of her lifeboats was found upside down. It looked like two rotten corpses fell out as the lifeboat upright.
Don't worry, there'll be no corpses. There's none in this game. Well, there is like this, but geez, stop tipping over.
The ship had sunk.
That's nasty! They're both hideous! Kill them!